Hello, everyone. Welcome to the Millionaire Dentist Podcast, brought to you by Four Quadrants Advisory. On this podcast, we break down the world of dentistry finances and business practices to help you become the millionaire dentist you deserve to be. Please be advised, we do speak with an honest tongue and may not be safe for work.
Hello and welcome to another episode of The Millionaire Dentist. I am your host, Jarrod Bridgman. Casey Hires is out at the moment. He is working with some clients at the moment. So I brought in Steve Levy, Pipes, the man with the golden voice. Steve, how are you?
Hey, Jarrod. How are you doing?
Doing great. Steve, I bring you in at the end of every year for something we call like the year-end tax wrap-up. And these are things that practice owners and business owners in general should probably keep in mind as the year winds down.
Yeah, absolutely.
So let me ask you, a lot of practice owners and stuff will give out holiday bonuses to their employees.
Right.
Can you kind of walk me through what needs to be done with that?
Yeah, this is about the time when you see practice owners paying out bonuses, and you can't just sort of give it to them and that's the end of the story, because the relationship between you as the owner and your employee is an employer-employee relationship. So any payment that you give them really is compensation.
So this would include non-cash mm-hmm. payments or whatever as well, a gift of some sort.
Gift cards typically. So what we recommend, one of two things, but they both should be considered for it. You can obviously just give them a bonus through their regular payroll system. Not something we commonly see as far as bonuses, because gift cards or cash is typically what we see. So in that second instance, what we recommend is that you give them the money, no problem, and then report the people that received that money or gifts, report that to your payroll provider so that they can do what's called grossing up for taxes, which means that the net amount they receive is still the same. They still receive that amount, but there are Social Security and Medicare taxes on that amount. So essentially it brings that amount higher as far as reported in their compensation to reflect that you're kind of covering their Social Security and Medicare withholding.
Is there a minimum where that would take effect, or is it any and all?
It's really any and all. There's no, because like I said, it is compensation, considered compensation no matter what amount. There's really not a thing called gifts to your employee because of that relationship, that it's for typically services given at the time or even prior.
You said it's not as often that you see them just do like a monetary bonus through mm-hmm. the payroll system.
Yeah.
Between those kind of two options you shown, is there an easier or less complicated path?
Yeah, certainly the first option, just saying, hey, here's whatever amount, like $1,000 bonus. It's compensation, so it's going to have withholding.
And it's already kind of automatically taken care of.
Yeah, it's already taken care of. The other one, and so with the second option of just kind of giving the money or gifts, the best suggestion there is to let your payroll provider know as ahead of time as possible so that they can not cram to get that in, especially since it's usually given at the end of the year and that has to be reported on the W-2 and everything.
With it being, if it's done through payroll like that, would it be taxed as a bonus then too with like the slightly higher rates?
Yeah, okay. Most likely.
Okay, yep. Steve, okay, keeping with the holiday theme, a lot of companies are gearing up to, within the next couple of weeks, do a holiday party.
Absolutely.
I know ours is in a week and a half.
That's right.
I'm pretty stoked about that.
Absolutely.
Can't wait to make our owner buy me all kinds of nice food and drinks. But Steve, how does the holiday party work with taxes and mm-hmm. I'm assuming Well, walk me through that. The right words.
So it's kind of the exception to a lot of rules in what you can actually write off for meals and entertainment. When you have a holiday party, the normal rule is you can't write off entertainment and you only get 50% of what you write off for meals. Well, this is a different situation. It's a holiday party. It gets 100% write-offs for both. And so it's and you don't just have to have it during this time. It's usually
entertainment and group, food.
Right.
So we can have like the Rockettes show up.
Whatever, you know, all that would be fantastic.
Right. I'm into that.
I heard that's actually happening, but that would be really great. But anyway, so, and it doesn't just, it's not just restricted to holiday parties. It can be company parties of like summer parties or that kind of thing. Now, I can't
so just crazy. a standard dinner with your department.
Yeah.
Wouldn't.
So no, not that. It's got to be kind of a company-wide occasion, which can be at really at any time. But holiday is usually what we see
right.
around that time. But it's the exception to a lot of rules, which actually we'll get into as the next topic. But yeah, go crazy. You'll get 100%
right
off.
All right. So next up would be, you'd mentioned that outside of the company-wide holiday parties and 100% tax write-off with those, there is, you said, usually like a 50% thing with just meals in general. Right. So you said, the notes you wrote me, so I know what to ask, that there was a deduction change in for 2023 with the meals?
That's right. Okay. So it had been for several years now since the Tax Cuts and Jobs Act that specifically for purchases from restaurants that you got to write off 100% of the meals that you purchased from restaurants,
okay.
Takeout, in person, whatever, not groceries. That wasn't part of it. But starting in 2023, that's reverted back to just the 50% write-off rule.
Which obviously not great, but it's still something.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, it's still available. Like I said, the holiday party is an exception for that. But,
we are a proactive firm here. And so when that changed, I know we probably reached out to our clients and let them know. But is there anybody you think out there that's going to get caught not knowing about that?
I would say, I mean, because it's been the rule for, a few years now since that act around 2018. So it's
one of those things where you probably shouldn't have. Mm-hmm. Bet your eggs on, place your bets on being like, well, I'm going to get 100% of this back.
Right.
So you
right.
did a dinner every week.
Yeah, definitely. Okay. So, but it could, if you're having a large meals expense, typically you'll get that 50% haircut. A lot of states were kind of doing it too. They were like, sure, federal law, but we kind of like the old way. So we're only going to give you 50%. You had to make an annoying adjustment for state to do that. But now everybody's kind of in sync, federal and state, and back to the old ways.
Okay. So. Does that make it easier on your end when you're doing people's taxes?
It's fine either way. We know what to put where and what's
That's good because I don't. So that's why I appreciate your expertise when you come in here and whenever I guilt you into doing my taxes next time, that'd be nice. With 2024 coming up, you and I had sat down and talked about the IRS and retirement changes, things like that. Do you mind going through just a quick kind of cover of the inflationary changes for 2024?
Yeah, no problem. So, like we talked about, it wasn't a boost as much as from 22 to 23 as far as limits that you can defer for 401k, but it's still some things did increase. So in 2023, you could defer for 401k purposes $22,500 for your 401k. 2024, it's just a $500 boost up to $23,000. Versus 22 was like around 20,000. So it was, it went up, but not as much.
And one of these changes, let me ask you real quick. With my 401k, I went into the computer and I started diverting all your funds into mine.
Okay.
Is that fine?
I mean, that I really would be very creative.
I really need to catch up.
It sounds like a kind of an Office Space type That's of right. deal where
it's just a quarter of a penny. It's fine.
It's just incremental. So. Now, the catch-up contributions, which, I'm catching up. You're catching up to take my
this
money.
This is after 55?
That's right.
Well, yes, you need to catch
50,
up now.
50.
50, my bad. 50,
so,
yes.
So that remained the same. That's still 7,500. And those are the two main ones. There's also, like we mentioned last time, a boost in how much compensation can be considered for the company match. It's it was $330,000 in 2023, and in 2024 it boosted up to $345,000.
If you need more information about this, listeners, there is an episode where Steve and I dive really into the nitty-gritty of that just a couple weeks ago. Let me ask you, you have written down here federal brackets.
Yeah.
So those have kind of shifted a bit?
They have. It was a big boost in from 2022 to 2023. And the change really was that more income was taxed at lower rates. And so really that means an overall tax hit was less. That's why there was a bigger boost from 22 to 23. There still is a boost in from 23 to 24, which just came out in November. So, for example, the jump of kind of the limit of the taxable income for the 24% bracket, that jumped $20,000. So, $20,000 more is at the 24% bracket versus the 32% bracket. So it was $24,000 between 22 and 23. So it did go down.
Okay.
But that difference between the 32 and 24%, I mean, that's a big rate difference, one of the bigger ones in the whole bracket system. There was also a jump in what's in the 32% bracket versus 35%, that increased 25% versus 30,000. And all this means is really more income taxed at a lower rate.
Okay.
And so if you had the same income in one year versus the next, the next one would be less. The tax would be less. So.
And that would be starting in next year, like January 1st.
That's right.
You know, it's December. This is the time of year where a lot of owners out there will be like, oh, shoot, I should probably make some end-of-year purchases here real quick. Let's get some stuff in here. And sometimes try to use that tax code, that tax
– right.
What's that tax code?
It's Section 179.
Section 179, which, I mean, if you need the equipment, is very beneficial.
Yeah.
If it's something you actually need to use.
Oh, sure.
But a lot of people will – try to use this as a way to lower their taxes.
Right.
Can you walk me through end of year purchases?
Yeah. So what we generally believe is that you shouldn't make expenses and purchases just to save taxes, because that's kind of chasing things. And you lose the money from the amount that you're spending for it.
Right.
Now, if you need it, by all means, go for it before the end of the year. It's
like if you actually need it, sit down and think about it.
Yeah. I mean, a business decision versus just, I just want to minimize my tax, just not pay the government anything.
I saw a video the other day on TikTok. This intern, they gave the intern a company card and he spent $18,000 on a bag, a Birkin bag, I think.
Okay.
But yeah, so I wouldn't do that.
Yeah. That's kind of rough. Now, one rule you have to make sure you follow is that you're not going to get the benefit in 2023 unless you place it in service by the end of the year. So that's really the
so
date
even if
that's
you
important.
Paid for it in 2023, right. if you haven't used it yet, it doesn't
right.
count.
Exactly.
So if you January 4th, you finally put it into motion, it would go in 2024?
That's right. Which okay. you wouldn't get that, you know, savings, the time value of money savings.
It'd be another year.
It would. So if you're gonna get it, if you're gonna buy that equipment, make sure you're getting it delivered and in some way are using it. So,
Steve, as always, you come in here and you just kill it. is there anything else you would like to add before we wrap up the tax wrap up?
Well, just think about the various topics we talked about, and especially the bonuses one. We often see that one where people believe, here's the money, we're good, right? No, there's some reporting there. By all means, throw the big holiday party, do all the meals expenses you want, but just note the less deduction, and don't fall for all the end of year purchase sales pitches for that, because make sure you need that.
Okay. Thank you, listeners. We really appreciate you tuning in. Please feel free to follow us on Spotify or subscribe to us on Apple Podcasts. If you like our podcast, please leave us a review. It always, always helps. Steve, thank you so much, and have a happy holiday and a good new year.
You as well.
That's all the time we have today. Thank you to our guests for their insight and for sharing some really great information. And thank you to you, the listener, for tuning in. The Millionaire Dentist Podcast is brought to you by Four Quadrants Advisory. To see if they might be a good fit for you and your practice, go on over to fourquadrantsadvisory.com and see why year after year, they retain over 95% of their clients. Thank you again for joining us, and we'll see you next time.